Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And you find yourself writing some DAX, but you need to take a peek at the model and some relationships between some tables in your model. What do you do? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, find yourself writing some DAX, and you need to verify that you're using the right columns and the relationship patterns. So what do? You toggle back, take a peek, then you go back to the report view because that's the only place you can write DAX. Not true. They just added something and I want to show you. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So typically what you would do when you're writing your DAX is you'd have to be in the report view, you right click, do new measure. So I'm gonna do measure, and I'm gonna write this measure called total shipped equals. And I'm gonna say calculate total sales amount, but I need to override the relationship because I know I have active and inactive relationships, but I don't remember the column names and things like that. What do? Well, you would switch over to the model view, take a peek, then come back to the report view. Well, now you can actually write DAX measures in the model view. I've been waiting for this forever. Check it out. So you switch over to the model view, get a little error, but that's okay. And guess what? The DAX editor is still there. Before, the DAX editor was not available when you switched to the model view. You had to do it in the report view, which was frustrating for me because I like to look at the model when I write my DAX because there's information in the model view that I just can't get from the fields pane or in the report view. So now I want to use relationship because I see now there's an active and an inactive relationship, and I want to use this one. Now I can hover here and I can see the table and the column names, but if I click this, check this out. Now I have this relationship editor right over here. Not only does it give me all the details about the relationship, but I can actually go and change some things about the relationship if I want to, but I can also open the relationship editor, but I don't need to do any of that stuff. I'm gonna go back here, find my measure. It's got the little warning sign there, and I can finish my measure up. So now I can say, use relationship. I know the table, so I want the date because it's in my editor. So watch this, it's in the editor, or I can just hover right here and it'll tell me that it's the internet sales ship date, but I'm in the model view. I'm in the model view. This is what's so great about it. Internet sales ship date. I don't have to go anywhere, and boom, now my measure's created. I didn't have to go back to the report view. I could do everything right here in the model view. Now I can write DAX measures in the model view, and I have this relationship properties window that shows me the details of my relationships right in the model view. Thank you so much, RBI team, for making this happen. Now I'm just waiting for dockable windows. All right, what do you guys think? What do you think about these new enhancements in the model view? Are you excited about them? I know I am. You know what to do. Post your comments in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.